Hello, everybody, and welcome to the DisGeek podcast. It's Minisode number 3, and I got to tell you, I almost didn't make this one. I had a plan of what I was going to do, and then that sort of fell to the wayside. But there is so much stuff going on. This has been an eventful week in the world of Disney Parks news. I'm leaving for vacation tomorrow, and I'm going to be gone. And then the following week, I'm going to be going to Las Vegas because my grandmother is sick, and I'm going down there to visit. She's 95 years old, so we're not sure what's happening there. So I gotta go to Vegas in a couple of weeks, right after my vacation that I'm taking. Like, by the time this episode comes out, I'm on vacation. Yay! But like I was saying, so much went on this past week. I just felt compelled. I wanted to record something and talk about this stuff, or at least report it, because, you know, it's what we do here. All right, so let's start things off with, this is like literally hot off the press. This is what prompted me to do the episode after all, because I I don't have time to do all this, so I'm going to be kind of going through this kind of quickly, but Disney literally just announced, as I'm sitting here, it's Friday, that the Main Street Electrical Parade is going to be returning to Disneyland. It is limited time engagement. They're going to start it on August 2nd. With nightly performances through September 30th. I don't understand. I mean, this is a great parade. I love this. I'm torn on this one and Paint the Night. I'm kind of unclear on why they're not bringing Paint the Night back, but they're bringing this. Maybe because Paint the Night's more expensive. Not sure what's going on there, but it's coming back. So if you're a fan of the Main Street Electrical Parade, and I am, here you go. It's coming. All right, up next. And here's another thing that's kind of unusual for Disney. They're doing this thing where if you're an annual pass holder, you could bring a friend and get a pretty big discount. You can get a one-day park hopper ticket for $99. That's incredible. I have a theory. Something's going on here. I'm starting to think, you know, with Star Wars Land, the aftermath or the effect, I guess, of Star Wars Land is that Disneyland, that the parks have been really, like, not crowded. It has been enjoyable, and I've been kind of on the bandwagon that Disney engineered that. They planned it that way. They started this reservation system that worked really well. They're doing this virtual queue system that we talked about last week, and that seems to be working really well. It's making Galaxy's Edge very manageable. The rest of the park is very manageable, and people are loving it. But I'm starting to think that maybe Disney's not loving it. Maybe Disney, maybe it's working too well. And that's why they're bringing this bring-a-friend discounting system in. Because they don't ever discount. It's not very often something like this. Bring a friend for cheap. That's unusual. At least I think it's unusual. And the fact that they're bringing Main Street Electrical Parade back, not nostalgia. You know, nostalgia brings people into the park. People want to see this parade. They love this parade. Again, twice, we thought it was glowing away forever, and here it is. It's back. So I don't know. Maybe there's something to this. Maybe Disney isn't quite as psyched as the parks being as empty as we are. I mean, they like the rest of us, have been planning for ginormous crowds. In fact, June 30th, this new parking lot, Pixar Pals will finally be opening June 30th. I believe the podcast will be out by then. Yes, Monday. So that is Sunday. So yeah, it's open. Should reword what I'm saying. The new parking lot, Pixar Pals, is now open. I hope you're enjoying it. So cool. It looks really nice. It's a parking lot. And a lot of people will be coming in through Mickey and Friends that entrance going forward. So it'll be interesting how that all plays out. We have a new ride, sort of, over at Disney California Adventure at Pixar Pier. Inside Out, Emotional Whirlwind is now open. This is the reskin of what we used to call the applesauce ride, which I believe was called Flicks Fun Flyers, something like that. Flicks Flyers, maybe. We love that ride. That was just a little ride that the kids always loved. But I'm glad to see that it's still around. They moved it over to Pixar Pier, where I believe the Malibu-mer used to be. And it's a cute little spinny ride. So glad that that's back. Speaking of California Adventure and opening day attractions, Soarin' Over California. Here's another thing that maybe goes to my argument that Disney's not happy with the crowd level that they've been getting. They're extending Soarin' Over California due to popular, you know, whatever. Due to popular demand. So they're going to extend it to August 31st. They should just keep it that. I mean, if they really want to make the fans happy, they should probably just leave it Soarin' Over California, my opinion. 4th of July is this, you know what? So no, it's not this weekend. It's next week. I'm sorry. My mind is scrambled right now because I'm kind of rushing, if you can't tell. but yeah, Disney Parks Live is going to be streaming a fireworks show, their 4th of July fireworks show over at the Magic Kingdom. So if you want to watch that, head on over to YouTube and check out the Disney Parks Live channel, which I believe is a Disney Parks blog. They've been streaming all kinds of cool stuff lately. And here's another one. So the next thing I want to talk about, let's talk about rumors. This was a big thing this week. The website WDWNT, they have a podcast as well. They have been posting lots of false information lately. They are, in my opinion, one of these websites that's very clickbaity. You know, they post sensational headlines. And they're just this, I think, honestly, in my opinion, today, these days, they will say anything and do anything to get traffic. That's my opinion. Could be wrong, but that's my opinion. The thing is with these rumors, well, first of all, there were two rumors. First, they came out with a story about how the Country Bear Jamboree over at Walt Disney World Magic Kingdom is going to be going away. So there's that. And then the other rumor that they put up is that the Enchanted Tiki Room over at Walt Disney World was going to get a Moana reskin, an overlay. And if I'm honest, that sounds something that Disney would do. I'm just being honest. Like, I think it's a credible rumor. I think they would do that. But what is unusual about both of these rumors is that Disney Parks blog came out and debunked them, which they usually never do. And it reminds me of years ago, we were on the bandwagon, the DisGeek podcast. We were on this bandwagon. Mice Chat reported that the subs were going away. And this was like shortly after the Finding Nemo and Friends Submarine Adventure, whatever it's called, that had just opened. It had only been open for maybe a year and a half. A year and a half, maybe 2 years at this point. And to me, this notion that it was going away was absolutely ridiculous. Like, that's insane. And I remember talking about that a lot on Twitter and just saying, like, yeah, right, the subs are going away. Like, I talked about it a lot. And I've never told this story because, well, and years has gone by, so I think it's probably safe to tell this story now. I was contacted on Twitter via private message from somebody who claimed to work in Imagineering. And they were just basically telling me, like, you're right. Like, the subs aren't going anywhere. And in fact, it never got beyond the this is an idea stage. You know, over at Imagineering, they talk about all kinds of different ideas. They just throw everything at the wall. What if we come up with so-and-so? Well, where would we put it? Well, we can get rid of the submarine, right? Okay, that's something to put on the table. But according to from what this person told me, it never even got further than that. And I said to him, why do they let Mice Chat get away with this? Why doesn't Disney say something? Like, debunk this and stop the nonsense. And he told me that they don't say anything. Disney doesn't say anything because they don't want to give the websites any kind of credibility. Like, it, like in other words, like, it's not worth our attention. They're just fan sites. Like, we've got work to do. That's kind of like the impression he gave me. So it's very unusual for Disney to respond to rumors. But I guess this one got a little out of hand. You know, all these websites, MiceChat, WDWNT, others, one called Theme Park Tourists, they're all I could say is just take these rumors with a grain of salt every single time, because if Disney doesn't say anything, it's not official. And, you know, all these sites post rumors and a bunch of BS. They all do it for clicks. And all these other websites that are not them, like, you know, don't play like you're all high and mighty or something like that, because you share the story. You help spread the rumor. And I'm part of that machine as well. I would not post a rumor unless I wouldn't post rumors. But if I saw that, this whole thing with the Tiki Birds, it happened and ended before I even knew what was going on. But I have to admit, if I saw the rumor, I would have shared the story. You know, so we're all like just part of the game. We're all trying to make clicks and do our thing and try to grow our audience. So I don't blame DWNT for that. Like, that's just what they're going to do. But just know who you're dealing with sometimes with some of these websites. And that's just happens to be one of the websites that I'm like, okay, well, when they say something, I'm going to pause because they're wrong, I think, more than they're right. But they have been right a couple of times. I think the craziest thing right now is that the guy who runs WDWNT right now is trying to claim that thanks to his rumor, Disney's changed their mind and decided not to get rid of the country bears thanks to the rumor. In other words, he saved it. I think he's crazy. I've said, if you recall last week in the last minisode, I said we were talking about the Main Street cinema and how they were putting merchandise in there and how Disney was kind of testing the waters to see what would happen. And I said Disney doesn't care. If they want to put merchandise in there, they will. They don't care about the fan reaction. And I'm not trying to dog on Disney or anything like that. It's just they don't care about the fan reaction. They'll take the hit. I think a lot of things that they have done would be reversed if they cared about the fan reaction. So I think if Disney wants to do an overlay with Moana with the Tiki Room, they'll do it. I think if they want to get rid of the country bears, they'll do it. I just don't think these ideas were on the table. Or maybe they were on the table and just they decided, well, we don't have the budget. We're not going to do it. Or maybe it's just sort of at a certain phase where they're thinking about it. Maybe sometimes, again, Imagineers come up with all kinds of ideas. And then even sometimes ideas make it to a stage where like they build models and commission all kinds of artwork and plan the whole thing out only for it to get canceled. It happens more often than you think. And so maybe a Moana Tiki Room was just something that at one time was on the table. But of course, these rumor sites just report it. But again, I just want to say, just so I can give WDWNT a little bit of credit, they did state since the beginning that it was a rumor. They never claimed this was happening, this is true. They just claimed that it was a rumor. But of course, he does it in such a way so that he can get as much clicks as possible, and he stirs up the community. And if he wants to be a professional blogger and make that money and get those clicks, I hate to say it, but that's what you do. And so, you know, they're good at it. They're a big site, and they're big enough that they got Disney's attention. MiceChat couldn't get Disney's attention. I mean, Disney would just ignore them. So, you know, whatever. Maybe he is claiming credit. He's either crazy or he is just very, I don't know, calculating, you know, but I don't know. I don't know the guy. I know of him. I know stories about him. Won't repeat here, but that's what happened. That was this week in Disney news. So that'll do it for this week's minisode. again, I'm not sure if I'm going to have one next week, only because I'm going off to Las Vegas to visit my grandmother. So we're going to just have to see how that goes. But thank you for listening. Show notes for this episode will be at disgeek.com/mini3. Please, please, please consider helping us, helping the show, helping us exist, helping us deal with our hosting costs by donating to Patreon. If you like what we do here, consider Patreon the tip jar, right? You go to the Santa Monica Pier and there's some guy playing the saxophone and he has a hat. This is the hat. Patreon.com/DisGeek. That's the hat. You can find us on Instagram and Twitter at DisGeek Podcast. And you can also find us on Facebook as well. Thank you all for listening. Thanks for dealing with my rushed episode. But hey, that's what this is supposed to be. It's a mini-sode, right? Booyah. See you guys later. Bye-bye.